What is poppin', fam? My name is Brennan Myers, and in today's video, we're gonna be talking about symmetry. Left to right, biceps, chest to legs, everything. We're gonna figure it out. So buckle up, and let's get started. So when we talk about symmetry, first of all, I'm gonna give you an example. I've done a video of this a long, long time ago about how to make one side look the same as the other. First, here, let me just show you mine. Look at this bicep insertion here, and look at the bicep insertion here. This might mean a different origin or the way it's structured on my bones, whatever. It might be a little bit different. That's okay. No, I've never torn my bicep, but to someone that is really, really well versed in strength and conditioning or exercise physiology, they might say, oh, you must have torn something. But that's not the truth. The truth is, my body's just developed over time this way. And many times it comes from habits when we were younger. And if you are young, if you are in your teenage years or even your early 20s, you have an opportunity right now to even change those habits, which will then affect your musculature and the way it looks. And that's the truth. So you ever seen winging where one scap's maybe a little bit wider or a little bit upward rotation and one scap's here? I'm talking about your back, right? Well, a lot of this stuff comes down to posture and how are you standing? How are you sitting? How are you sleeping? All these different things take a huge, huge part in your musculature, your body, right? Look at my legs. My legs are pretty symmetrical, right? But actually, one leg is that much longer than the other. And I found this out by my mom about two years ago. I almost ran into a wall, to be honest. I was so pissed. No, I'm kidding. But the way you got to approach it is, I'm going to give you some tips here, okay? Number one, if one side of your body is bigger than the other and you're a little bit younger, look at your posture. So number one, look at your posture. Look at the screen, you see posture. Number two, you wanna focus on how you're sleeping. That's part of number two. And then also how you're sitting. So everything is gonna be a neutral spine. You wanna try and keep your chin suspended here, your neck suspended, and making sure that your back's not like this. It's not overarching here. I'm not gonna use any science terms because half of you might not even understand it. So you don't want your back to be arching. And also when you're training, number three, how are you working out? Are you doing movements? When you're doing pull-ups, are you like this? Or are you staying tight with your core and pulling correctly? All these things play a huge role, okay? Also, when you are training, you wanna look at how your muscles are reacting or how your musculature is. So another example, if you're doing a pull-up, right? Or actually, if you're doing a overhead press or just something on the ground, any bodyweight train, any movement really, and you're pushing up and one shoulder is actually higher than the other, this has most likely been going on for a very, very long time and you haven't even seen it. The reason being is because it's just natural to you. And what you're really doing, there's musculature that's actually overcompensating. Maybe you hurt your shoulder a long time ago. Maybe you hurt the other shoulder a long time ago. Maybe your hip. Maybe you tore your hip flexor or you pulled your hamstring at one point. This has everything to do with the symmetry of your body. Also, if you are teenage, younger 20s, and you see, actually anybody, and you see that one muscle is a lot bigger than the other, and I'm talking about like a substantial difference, right? Mine are fine, okay? And I'm actually gonna get to an example with my shoulders because you'll understand a little bit more clearly as I give you the example. But if you're in that situation and one bicep is bigger than the other, whatever it is, or you feel like it's so much weaker, all I want you to do is increase the frequency for the week. So instead of just 2 days per week, let's say you're working chest, you need to get your chest bigger and one side of your chest a little bit bigger than the other side. Don't switch up the reps and stuff on one arm. You don't want to do that. But when you are doing any type of a barbell movement or you're doing a push-up or a clap push-up, whatever it is, concentrate on the weaker side. And when you concentrate more on the weaker side and you actually do more time under tension, so longer amount of work through the exercise, you'll notice a huge difference in how your muscle is activating and how it's growing. And a lot of the times, the muscle that's weaker or smaller isn't activating because of another injury or a long time injury or something that you haven't been taking care of for the longest time. Surprisingly, my hip flexor has had a lot to do with my left shoulder. And when I healed my hip flexor, my shoulder got a lot better. So make sure you're looking at everything. It's not just one thing. So really, really focus again on just that mind muscle connection. Just, hey, I'm gonna focus here and make sure I'm squeezing and activating as much as possible. My left glute had the biggest problem for a while, and then I herniated my disc on my right side, and my sciatica on my right side got all messed up. These things have a lot of common occurrences just because this is life. This is the anatomy of the body. This is the exercise physiology of the body. So getting back to it, you want to make sure that everything is in the proper position. So retract, depress your scaps. You want to make sure neutral spine, again, tightening in that core. Maybe one foot is coming off the ground a little bit more than the other. That will actually have an effect on your bench while you're benching. So keep that in mind. Frequency, 3 times a week. Now, you're not going to go crazy heavy every single time, obviously. So for instance, me right now, I'm developing my upper chest and my shoulders. So as you can see, it's doing pretty well, right? And it's growing. And Taylor is someone that has watched the growth of this, and it's worked. So Monday, and it all switches week to week. So you generally do about 4 weeks. It's like a 4-week program. Monday, I go a little higher volume. Wednesday, I go a little bit less volume, a little bit more weight, like a moderate day. And then on Friday, I really take it home with a lot of volume. So I'm hitting all three different levels, like pretty much close to intermediate to moderate, and then high intensity for the 2 other days. And I haven't hurt myself. I mean, I've been training for quite some time now for this prep, October 5th. So increase that frequency. You can also look at your rest periods in between sets. So my left shoulder is the one that I tore in 4 different places. It took me a long time to rehab. And surprisingly, it's still a little bit weaker than my right, but it's gotten stronger over time. If you see, probably like 3 or 4 weeks ago, I did a workout session, and I was doing overhead press with dumbbells, actually like 6 weeks ago. And I was going, and it was a high volume day. And what I started to realize is that my left shoulder was so fatigued towards the end of my training. So what did I do? I lowered the weight a little bit, and I made sure I got the same reps in on each side, dumbbells. And I went to the dumbbells, and that's another clue or another piece of advice for you to gain some more symmetry from right to left, is try a lot of dumbbell movements and controlled movements. A lot of the times when your core is really, really weak, your other muscles can't even grow as much. Also, a lot of times when you're not working as much on your legs, the other muscles in your body aren't able to gain as much muscle as you would like them to. It all comes down to growth hormone, it comes to testosterone, there's so many different things. The recruitment involved in leg days is pivotal to your training for upper body. Someone on my Instagram was just mentioning to me, hey Brennan, why are you doing legs twice a week? That doesn't make any sense. You're doing men's physique, you don't need legs. Wrong. The reason why I've grown so much is because I've incorporated legs again. It recruits a lot more. It's a lot more energy output. What happens when ATP output is through the roof? You know, creatine is a huge involvement in that. It increases ATP output. So during your workouts, you can actually train harder for a longer period of time. So actually, I'm conditioning my body. I'm conditioning my upper body to be able to push more weight or pull more weight. So that frequency is super, super, super important, because you're also conditioning your muscles. And this is one of the main things that I'm going to say, is that if your muscles are not conditioned, a lot of the times it's going to translate to how big they're going to get. That's why when you look at proper training programs, they involve muscular endurance, they involve hypertrophy training, which is building size, and then also strength and power. And when they don't incorporate all these different things, you see it in the results. You take one test subject, you take another test subject, and one person has imbalances, the other person has imbalances, and one person is just focusing on hypertrophy training and strength training, and then the other person is focusing on all three styles of training. Guess what? If you have the muscular endurance, what do you think is going to happen if you're pushing more weight for 8 to 12 reps for hypertrophy? It's going to be, you're going to be stronger. You're going to be at that 11 and 12 reps next level, rather than this guy. So what's gonna happen? Your symmetry is gonna be a lot better. Also, I highly suggest, if you're dealing with symmetry problems with your calves to your quads, suck it up. Honestly, suck it up. Look, my calves aren't that big, right? They're not. I mean, they're not small, but my quads and actually my hamstring, you can see my hamstring to adductor area, like how much bigger, how big it is, right? All I've done is sucked it up. I said, okay, I am gonna train my calves. I'm gonna work on my calves, but look, I walk 10,000 steps a day. I do cardio on the stair stepper. I sprint, I jump, I do plyos. I do a lot of legs. Like my calves, they've always been what they've been. Maybe they got a little bit bigger, but that's pretty much it. The way I look at it is, okay, it is what it is. And many of us in times like that, even with my bicep, I have to say it is what it is. If I was pissed off that my right bicep was shorter than my left, I would have, there's no way I would still be on earth. There's no way. Because I would have drove myself absolutely insane. My mind would be elsewhere. But the truth is, this can never be different. Even my abs, they're a little bit different, right? I have one side that you could see a little bit more of my abs, right? Even my lat spread, it's a little bit different. But that's why you can manipulate the way people see things, right? So keep all these different things in mind. Increase your frequency, get your rest, great posture. You don't want injuries. A lot of the times, these things can actually lead to injuries if you don't fix them or if you don't work towards them. And it's not gonna come easy. Consistency and dedication. These two, your best friends, scissors, cutting through life. I'm telling you, if you're not very, very serious about this and you're not serious about fixing your symmetry or your whatever your deal is, then it's not going to happen. And you're gonna see more and more problems. So fix it now. And that's pretty much all I can say. Anything else that I should say, Taylor?
I think you covered it all.
Everything?
Yeah.
So, first of all, don't worry so much if it's something that is just like your musculature, like that's how it is. Number two, just to summarize, make sure you're hitting that frequency, especially if you wanna get your legs bigger or whatever. It takes time, it takes a lot of time. You know, some people it takes 10 years to finally build the mass that they've been wanting. Other people it takes 2 years that they've been wanting. You know, your metabolism might be crazy, crazy high. My metabolism is great. It truly is. I have great genetics. At the same time, I train my ass off. He can attest to it. He watches me
every morning, 6 a.m.
Every morning. So it's all about your focus and really focusing on that muscle. And that's another thing. Focus on your muscle as you're moving. All right. So thanks for tuning in for another video. I really, really am enjoying these type of videos. You enjoying them?
Okay.
Yeah, they're super fun. I get to spread my knowledge of exercise physiology. I will say this, you can build symmetry with weights and with bodyweight training. And I don't want you to misconstrue anything that I've said in this. I don't, is misconstrued a fucking word? I don't even know.
Yeah.
I don't want you to miss what I'm saying. That's all I'm saying. When you're doing any bodyweight movements, it's just, again, it's mind-muscle connection. If you feel like one side's more activated than the other, focus more on that right side that you need to be working. And it's going to work, I promise you. It will work. We're not destined to have just every muscle in our body be completely different. It'll come. Just like trust the process, trust what you're doing, and it'll be all good. It's all good, right here, you see? It's all good. Anyways, thanks for tuning in for another video. If you have any other questions, any videos you would like me to touch on, discuss, whatever, comment down below. Really appreciate you. Remember, if you haven't subscribed, you probably should, because we do come out with podcasts. We have all this stuff happening. Create Your Nutrition, July 30th, bada bing, bada boom. Like, come on, guys. Come on. Join the fam. Keep on rolling. Keep on grinding. Also, the podcast every Tuesday and Friday. Quick Time Fridays are actually one of my most fun days ever, because I talk shit and I get to say whatever the hell I want on a podcast. I'm a mountain goat, they call me. I had actually yak today.
You ate the yak?
Yeah, I ate the yak.
How was it?
It was freaking yak.
Did it taste like?
And it's great. It's great. So thanks for tuning in. I'll see you next time. Peace. All the choices you make them again.